Greetings. I'm Evelyn Cook, and it is my honor to be your guide and to welcome you to the Mural Mile of Mountain City, celebrating our musical heritage. You know, our heritage goes back a long way because our ancestors brought with them a lot of music. They came basically from Ireland and Scotland, and they had a heritage of ballad making, which we have carried on in these mountains to this very day. You are going to see murals that celebrate that heritage of ballad making, some of the people who were involved, and some of the ballads that we honor. So we hope you have a wonderful visit. We begin our tour here at the Art Center. Inside the Art Center, all kinds of interesting things are going on. Artists are always busy. Outside, we have the first mural, which is the 1925 Fiddler's Convention. Now, that Fiddler's Convention was held right here in the old high school building. And it is a watershed event in the history of country music. Now, in spite of the fact that radios were new in 1925, N.C. Parsons set up a broadcast here. The Buster Brown Shoe Company put up a $20 gold piece, ensuring that every notable musician in the Southeast would make the trip to the Fiddler's Convention in Mountain City. Among those musicians were the Hillbillies, who gave one of their earliest performances here. Also present was our own local G.B. Grayson, who was to team up with Henry Whitter not long after and record Train 45. That Train album sold over 50,000 copies in 5 years, giving Grayson enough money to build a new house for his family in Laurel Bloomery.
Train 45 leaving Terminal Station, Atlanta, Georgia.
We move on to the train mural. In those early days, trains had become an important part of life, opening up our isolated county to the outside world of travel and commerce. And trains inspired lots of music. In fact, it was a train song that inspired the title for our yearly festival of traditional music, Long Journey Home. And train songs inspired our local artist, Temple Reese, to create the train mural here on Main Street.
Well, that smoke horizon, and it surely is a train. Surely is a train, Lord, it surely is a train. Black smoke horizon, and it surely is a train. I'm on my long journey home. Lost all my money, but it's
on down the street, we come to the mural created by Christy Dunn, called The First Sunrise. It's interesting to note that her title comes from the fact that Johnson County sees the first sunrise in Tennessee.
Now somebody stole my old coon dog, which they bang and die. Run them big coons off, fancy, loose and try.
This mural features Clint Howard, Fiddlin' Fred Price, and their sons Clarence and Kenny. That group teamed up with Clarence Tom Ashley and introduced to the world the young Doc Watson. That was in 1960s, and a New York newspaper of the time stated that those four musicians put the folk in folk music.
I went up on the mountain,
with my horn a blow. Well, I saw a purple guy going on down the road. Somebody stole my old coon dog and wished they'd bring him back. Run them dead coons all the past, let them see me cry.
Later, Fred and Clint, along with their sons, Clarence and Kenny, recorded the ballad of Finley Preston. This ballad tells the story of the last hanging in Tennessee, and it occurred just across the street on the grounds of the county courthouse. This ballad was one of the very first recorded by the Rounder label, a famous label in country music circles. It is important to note that those musicians, the Prices, Howards, Tom Ashley, and Doc Watson, all played a significant role in passing country music on to the next generation. Proof of that can be seen in the large number of our students who participate in the JAM program, the Junior Appalachian Musicians, and in the Long Journey Home Festival, and finally in the many front porch pickings still popular to this very day. Next, we come to the Tom Ashley mural, based on the legend that Ashley always liked to try out new songs on his pony.
Went out last night for to take a little round. I met a little Cindy and I blowed her down. I run right home and I went to bed. A 44 smoke list under my head.
The Tom Ashley mural was the first in our series, created in 2013 by our noted artist, Christy Dunn. It must be emphasized that this mural and the entire series to follow were inspired by a conversation between artist Dunn and Joe Wilson. Although Joe had become a famous folklorist and a National Heritage Fellow, he didn't lose touch with his home county. His expertise was valuable to us because he knew folk art and he knew our county. He had always been interested in country music. When I taught Joe in high school, he would often come to class with bleary eyes, having been up half the night rehearsing with his little country band. Little did I realize at that time that he would one day establish and direct a department of folk art at the Smithsonian. Joe Wilson not only inspired artist Dunn, he reminded all of us of our rich heritage that had almost been forgotten. The Tom Ashley mural reminds us of Ashley's wide influence on country music and his influence on an entire generation of notable musicians, from John McCutcheon to Jerry Garcia. In fact, Garcia was so taken by Ashley's lassie-making tuning and his clawhammer style that he spent an entire week with Tom trying to learn some of his techniques. You will note a marker near the mural, and it was placed there by the Tennessee Music Pathways in honor of Ashley's contribution to Tennessee's musical heritage.
Gonna build me old cabin on a mountain so high, so I can see Willie as he goes.
Move on to the next mural on the old Muse hardware. Here you see a portrayal of the capture of Tom Dooley, which occurred down the road on Little Doe Creek.
Hang your head, Tom Dooley, hang your head and cry. Kill poor Laura Foster, you know you're bound to die.
The hero of that story is Colonel Grayson. Now, the story goes that the North Carolina posse, who had tracked Dooley to Doe Creek, wanted to hang him on the spot. Colonel Grayson disagreed and held him off with his gun and arrested Tom, making certain that he would get a fair trial back in Wilkesboro. The fiddler pictured in the mural is G.B. Grayson, a nephew of Colonel Grayson. Often referred to as Blind Bandman Grayson, he was indeed blind, but that did not prevent him from making the first recording ever of the Tom Dooley story in 1928. G.B. Grayson's life was unfortunately cut short in a tragic accident, but he had lived long enough to make an indelible mark on American music. The 40-some songs that he recorded have all become standards of both bluegrass and old-time music.
You took her on the hillside, as God Almighty knows. Took her on the hillside, and there you hit her soul.
In the corner close to the mural, you will see the portrait of yet another Grayson. We can't forget old Frank, because he belonged to our generation and was one of the last of the old-time fiddlers. Frank was the great-nephew of Colonel Grayson. All the Graysons were related. It's interesting to note that these mountains have inspired music ever since the early settlers arrived. Songs of loneliness, deaths, betrayals. Songs that spoke of their lives as they cleared a wilderness and established homes. And the mountains inspired our artist and counselor, Temple Reese. She recently led an art and renewal workshop, and the participants of that workshop created the mural in honor of Tom and Fran Atkinson, founders of WMCT, our local radio station.
I wandered again to my home in the mountains, where in life's early dawn, I was happy and free.
We now come to the series of murals on the Farmer State Bank called The Legacies. This series was a community effort designed and led by artist Christy Dunn. The six murals commemorate influential albums by Johnson County musicians. First, we have House of the Rising Sun, recorded in 1927 by Tom Ashley. He called it the Rising Sun Blues and is said to have learned the song from his grandfather Enoch.
There is a house down in New Orleans. They call
Next is Handsome Molly, one of G.B. Grayson's biggest hits. The song has roots in the old country that we mentioned earlier, was one of several ballads brought to Appalachia by our ancestors. Handsome Molly has been re-recorded by musicians the world over to include such icons as Bob Dylan and Mick Jagger.
I think of Handsome Molly wherever she might be. Oh, let me hear you.
beautiful little rock church reminds us that our own Tom Ashley arranged the version of Amazing Grace that is used in churches now all across the nation since the recording he made in 1960s. In fact, he is responsible for popularizing what has become one of America's very favorite hymns. Train 45 was on the flip side of Handsome Molly. It was one of several songs that were passed down and recorded by other Johnson County musicians and is still going strong.
Going up the track to bring the little woman back. I'm tired of living all alone.
A collection of noteworthy Johnson County albums just wouldn't be complete without the Ballad of Tom Dooley. Here we see the infamous Tom playing his fiddle and sitting on top of his casket on his way to being hanged.
This world and one more than where you reckon I'll be. Hadn't it been for Grayson, I'd have been in Tennessee.
Another sad tale is that of Finley Preston, which we mentioned earlier. Preston was hanged for the murder of Lily Shaw, but it is speculated that he might not have been guilty.
A great crowd has gathered around the jail today to see my execution and hear what I have to say.
The last of the legacy murals is dedicated to the album Old Time Music at Clarence Ashley's. This album has a storied history. John McCutcheon swears that it was this album that made him drop out of college and become a banjo player. Was Doc Watson's first, and it was recorded in a little shack behind the Clint Howard home on his farm. Now, from that humble beginning, the album was inducted into the National Recording Registry at the Library of Congress in 2013, along with Simon Garfunkel's The Sound of Silence and Pink Floyd's Dark Side of the Moon. Not a bad ending for a first album recorded in a shack on a remote farm in East Tennessee.
There's the whole gang, Fiddlin' Fred Price and Sally Ann.
This brings us back to Heritage Square and a day in the life of a song created by artists Christy Dunn, Lewis Chapman, and Temple Reese.
Having up on the mountain to get me a sack of sand. Red Clum said his dog's on me and a
Blossom slapped his hand.
Oh, boy!
Whoa, me, lassie. Eat your seat, Miss Liza Jane, that me's gonna run away.
You will note that the day starts with the morning in the kitchen, goes on to molasses making.
I would knock my toss him down and tell you the reason why. Mix along and swing, Lord, I'm afraid she'd never die. Well, boy, whoa, mule, I say, keep your seat, Miss Liza Jane, that mule run away.
And finally, to sitting by the radio, probably listening to the Grand Ole Opry. Thank you so much for taking the time to have our tour of the Mural Mile. We hope you enjoyed it all. Now we invite you to spend time relaxing in the Art Center. There you will find coffee and tea, good conversation, and a variety of locally made Appalachian arts and crafts. We hope to see you again real soon. And as Robert Porterfield, the great founder of Barter Theater, always said, if you like us, talk about us. And until we meet again, be safe on your long journey home.